Hello, welcome to this tutorial dedicated to TinkerCAD, a free online CAD tool you can use to learn CAD design and make experiments in 3D. In just 10 minutes, we are going to see everything you need to know to start using it. To access TinkerCAD, open its page and log in with your email address. You will enter into the main dashboard, where you can start any 3D CAD design, an electrical circuit simulation, or animations with Codeblocks. In this video, we won't see the circuit projects. Let's start with a new 3D design project by going to Create, 3D Design. Your project opens up on the main preview, with editing tools at the top, and features on the right panel that you can hide and show. From here, you can access several ready-made templates, including geometrical shapes, 3D text, character designs, and more. You can also import any 3D project you have by using the Import button above. There are different kinds of objects you can import from the right panel. Most of these are shapes that you can select and place on the preview. In this process, you can right-click and drag to orbit around, and use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Click the preview to drop the object on the ground, represented by the blue workplane grid, or directly on any object surface. Once you drop any shape, click on it to select it, and open the dialog box on the right with all the properties for such object, such as radius, smoothness, and size, and length, width, and height. These parameters may vary based on the object you're editing. Go to Solid to set color and transparency level, and switch to Whole to subtract such shape from others, as we are going to see later in this video. This can also be used to make the object more transparent. Select Scribble to brush sketches on the work plane. Click on the preview to switch to a 2D environment and start brushing, checking the 3D result from the top right corner. At the bottom, use the Erase tool to delete brushes, and enable Shape tools to drop or erase complex shapes. In this case, click and drag to set the radius until you close the shape. Go to Done to apply the brushes, and return to the main 3D workspace. Focus the camera on the object selected by pressing the F key. To drop 3D text, select Text, and click on the preview, adjusting color, text content, and font on the right. To edit any object, click on it to select it, and drag it to move vertically and horizontally, keeping the object attached to the ground. You also get instant measurements from the corners of the object base, with units set from settings at the bottom right corner. Choose millimeters, inches, or bricks, and resize the blue work plane if you need more space for your project. Move any object while holding the Alt key to make fast copies from it, and head to the top left corner to copy, paste, delete the selected object, or undo/redo actions made. A selected object gets several nodes, showing quick measurements when hovered over. Drag the white nodes to resize the base and hold down the Shift key to lock its aspect ratio. Drag the black nodes to resize in a single direction instead. Use the black cone to adjust the height with respect to the ground work plane, and the arrows to rotate. In this case, use the internal circle to snap, or the external one to avoid any snapping. As you move and resize, you snap to the workplane grid. You can customize snappings or turn them off from the Snap Grid option at the bottom right corner. Hit the R key to drop a ruler and measure distance between objects, whereas use the N key to drop notes and comments within the project. the work plane fixes the reference plane to consider when moving and editing. You can change it by enabling the Workplane tool in the top right corner and clicking on any object face. At this point, you will work with the new plane in orange color with blue projections easing the editing process. You can return to the original plane by enabling the Workplane tool and clicking anywhere. When you start getting loads of objects in your project, you may select any and head to the top right corner to manage it. Use the first button to prevent any modification on it. Click on the second button to hide the object until you click on the light button above. To manage multiple objects, click and drag over these to select them all in order to move and edit these together. You can also click on group to make these a unique object to select and edit, coming back with ungroup if necessary. In the same way, you can group multiple overlapping objects to design a single and more complex shape. If any object is a whole, this is subtracted from the other solid objects, easing your design. Make sure to use ungroup to undo and come back to the individual objects. From the top right corner, you can use the mirror tool to flip the selected object, or the cruise tool to move an object base on the surfaces of other objects. To check your project from different perspectives, use the 3D view cube in the top left corner. Additionally, switch to other preview styles in the top right corner to visualize your creation differently. Check these out! Now TinkerCAD comes with the Sim Lab, a new environment to make live simulations. Select an object to get information on the right, such as friction, density, mass, and volume, or change its material. With scene settings, configure material, mass, and density for the ground, and select one or more throwable objects to use in your next simulation. Start the simulation by hitting play in the bottom left corner, and click to throw objects against others. The simulation takes into account the gravity force and pulls up all objects that merge with the work plane. The simulation gets saved so that you can replay it or check specific moments in time. You may reset it if you want to change the original object placement. You can also create dependencies to rotation axis, directions, or pivots with the connectors in the bottom right corner. Enable the axle connector to make an object rotate around the axis indicated by the blue marker. Place the axis and attach the connector to the object that must move around it by dropping the circle, turning an orange color. This is the result. You can also attach a second blue circle to another item so that the two objects remain connected when in motion. The slider connector moves the object under the orange circle only through the direction set by the connector, whereas the pivot connector links two objects, one that is free to move under an orange circle and another to use as pivot under a blue circle. Now let's see how to save and export your project. Projects are automatically saved online, and you can also go to Send to download your current project preview as an image, or share it to Autodesk Fusion or Google Classroom. Click on the TinkerCAD logo to return to the dashboard and retrieve all your saved projects. Click on one and go to Download to export your project in STL or OBJ format for 3D printing and designs, or an SVG for 2D laser cuts. With TinkerCAD, you can also realize animations by going to Create, Code Blocks. Drag and drop actions in order, from creating and editing shapes, to applying dead times, or performing math step by step. make sure to check the tutorial section to get more help. And go to Gallery to find and remix projects made by the community. Thank you for watching this video. Make sure to check our YouTube channel and website for more free and outstanding guides on 3D designs and much more.